crazy story here. So, as you guys recall, the new White House communications director, the new hire was Anthony Scaramucci, a very random guy, a very Italian-sounding New Yorker guy. And, of course, he was a hedge fund manager, and he touted himself as representing Wall Street. There was a clip where he was at a town hall in 2010 where he effectively was whining, saying that Obama was cracking down too hard on Wall Street. He is now fired. He was escorted out of the White House. He is gone. He is done. I believe in total, his whole job lasted 10. He lasted 10 days. So, there were jokes going on Twitter, of course, because he's the meme lord. I saw a tweet that said, RT, if you had a period longer than Scaramucci. Hilarious. Absolutely hilarious. Who could have saw this coming? I'm not totally sure. Did he deserve it? Absolutely. I thought in terms of reserving oneself, he actually did a worse job than Sean Spicer. And Sean Spicer was throwing lies left and right, whether or not he wanted to. I mean, Trump was the person he was representing. But here is what The Hill says. They say, President Trump on Monday removed Anthony Scaramucci as communications director, ending a tumultuous tenure in the West Wing that lasted just 10 days, so only 10 days. The brash former hedge fund manager lost his job on the same day that Homeland Security Secretary John Kelly assumed his new role as Trump's chief of staff. There was actually also a report that John Kelly, who is now the chief of staff taking place of Reince Priebus, he was really angry that Trump had fired Comey, and he was going to resign in solidarity with James Comey. Don't know what happened to that, but now I'm sure he's enjoying his position, his new role as chief of staff. The White House cast the move as Scaramucci's decision. Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders said in a statement that, quote, he felt it was best to give Chief of Staff John Kelly a clean slate and the ability to build his own team. So Scaramucci was a big guy on trying to crack down on the leaks. Of course, he didn't even get time to do that. But if you recall, additionally, his wife had a kid, and then they divorced. And now he has lost his job. So he's gone through quite a bit, quite a tumultuous ride. Of course, we had that huge meltdown with the reporter on the phone, basically calling out his whole bunch of his colleagues. Truly remarkable. But Scaramucci is out. What's up, guys? It's Sawhill here. You guys are watching The Progressive Voice. Make sure you guys click subscribe down below. We're fighting Donald Trump tooth and nail, and we need your help.